miss him so much. Ladies, this is your day. President Obama, let me know. Happy Mother's Day. Right here, it says right here, if you would, if you can see that, it says Happy Mother's Day to someone who did a great job raising her children and her husband. So what I want to do is take a look at our confession for the year and use that, take a look at supporting and also undergirding the whole idea of our Mother's Day as well. So let's repeat together. This is together, our first part of our annual theme. I am a visionary. Why? I see myself as God sees me. So again, if you can't see this mug right here, there's a mug right here that says, Mom, great job. I'm awesome. Happy Mother's Day. Some folk in here need to see yourself as being awesome and also abundant and overflowing. Can you give God a hand clap of praise for them as well as in Jesus' name? Second, let's repeat this together. I am revolutionary. Why? Overcome all obstacles through Christ. Now, at this part, if you can kind of look over here, it is the little boy right here saying, see, I told you. And then the little girl says, so that's how she does it. So he goes and gives a little superwoman cape and says, Happy Mother's Day to all our super moms everywhere. Every mom being a super mom, please join me in giving God one more hand clap of praise in Jesus' name. So if you can read this with me, please. This is also under being this idea of being revolutionary. Read me with this, please. Thank you for giving me life. And thank you for not taking it back during my teen years. Amen. There's some folks right here dealing with folks in teens right now, so you know what I'm talking about here. So let's go to the next part. I am what? Extra. Why? I no longer achieve, believe, or receive, contrary to the word of God. Now, this part right here, you can see from where you are, says, the extraordinary mother. Would you just join me one more time in giving God a hand clap of praise? Every mother is the extraordinary. Let's read it. If you can read that, please. Happy Mother's Day to someone who carried me 9 months physically and for 29 years financially. Oh, Lord. This is supposed to have been carried beyond that point as well. Amen. Now, this part, I know you can't see. It says, Mom's favorite saying. So I'm just going to go down a few of these. First one says right here, what point of no don't you understand? These are what moms will say. Second part, I don't care who started it. Mm-hmm. Y'all ever heard that before, Mom? All right, wait until your father gets home. Number four, your face is going to freeze like that. Number five, no one said life was fair. Number six, go to your room. Number seven, beds are for sleeping and not jumping. That's a little boy. Number eight, eat your vegetables. Number nine says, now this must y'all know this well, I don't know is not an answer.
Mm-hmm. True.
Last one, because I said so. That's why.
Amen.
That stands for mom. All right, so here we go. Let's keep it going now. I operate where? In the spirit of exceptional excellence. Now, this little face right here. You mean to tell me your real name is not mom? Since at some point, all these little kids think for years and years, all the first of the mom's name was mom, or in that case, it's Jerry, it's Jerry's mom. So in this case, second one right here. Now, everybody here knows a mom like this. Happy Mother's Day to mom. The original seatbelt. That mom hit your head go down immediately. So the original seatbelt here. Last thing. I overcome, overtake, and walk in overflow. Now, you may not be able to see all this, but I love this one here. It says, this is the Motherhood, Inc., Human Resources. It says right here, this is the person applying for the job right here. This is our little point is working again. Thanks to Uncle Rodney. It says right here, one vacation day a year, that's all I get. And then the one behind the desk says, we call it Mother's Day, but technically you still have to work. All right. Now, you got to watch this now. Now, watch this poster, and I need you to look in the corner for this one. And you can read this with me together. Let's read this together. We are making breakfast for Mother's Day, but we have one question. Now, look in that little corner here. How do you work this thing? All right, Mother's Day. Now this is where we end on this. Let's repeat this together. I believe in love at first sight because I love my mom since I opened my eyes. Come on, God, you got another thing that I pray for our mothers here. So again, so at this point, God bless mothers. God bless mothers. For one more hand clap of praise for all God's mothers. Please join me in standing and give God a hand clap of praise. Especially if people are going to give God a hand clap of praise for all the mothers in the name of the Lord. So this week, this whole month, we're talking about overcoming, overtaking, and overflowing. Our focus has been on overcoming, which we'll talk about today. We'll pick up overtaking and overflowing for the remaining parts of the Sunday as well. So again, we've already talked about this now. This is revolutionary. Get this part again. Let's repeat this together. I am what? What? I overcome some. A few. One. All obstacles have through Christ. Now, so what are obstacles? We spent some time last week talking about this, and we'll just review very quickly. Obstacles. Now, this is what we're talking about. Like, you're trying to go forward, and something's in the way. You're trying to go forward, and something may be pulling you back. So this is representing whatever the obstacle is. Here we are going down this road of life, and an obstacle is there. So what is an obstacle then? So let's repeat now again. So now this visually helps us understand what we talked about last week. Again, you should have this in your notes. Where does it say up? An obstacle is what? Obvious barriers stopping. All right, so there's a barrier here. Would you not agree that there's a big barrier? It's obvious. An obstacle is not something that may be insidious and unseen. A barrier, oftentimes, an obstacle is something that it can be visibly seen, and it's an obvious barrier. But of course, there's some kind of way people are not where they ought to be. You know what I'm saying? There's some kind of way people are not where they should be. Some kind of way that people should be here, but operating here. Every teacher knows what that's like, to have children in your classroom that have all this potential, but decide to put their pants down and not comb their hair and try to end up being cool and fail instead of doing all comb. The idea was, so there's an obvious barrier stopping what? Keep going. Triumph. This barrier, these obvious barriers are stopping triumph. And also they're causing something. This barrier here is stopping something, but it's also causing something. It's stopping, first of all, triumph. But it's causing, lastly, limitless extra stress. That stress came and stress comes when this obvious barrier is in front of us that keeps us from going forward. And the point is, sometimes we're not handling that. Let me share with you. God never created us to walk around with stress and weight and all those other things we're carrying around. Can you say amen to that? God never created us like that. Back in the Garden of Eden, the only thing Adam had to do was to go name some animals. We were never created to walk around with all this extra stress. What does an obstacle do? This obstacle is an obvious barrier that stops triumph and causes limitless, extra stress. So let's repeat this again. I am revolutionary. Why? I overcome what? All obstacles through Christ. This barrier is here. And here's why I know what many of us are. Many of us have this barrier in front of us. And we have decided there's no way to overcome it. Amen? So that's why this is the confession. So we are confessing. When we say it, we will see it. Too many of us are waiting to see it before we say it. We start saying it first. We call those things. We call those things which be not, as they we already have. So I'm not going to wait until I see my breakthrough, and wait until I see my blessing, and wait until I see my words removed. I'm going to already say it before I see it. I tell you, if you ever want to look at a living testimony of that being operation, it was when Sister Neal found out she had to go through treatment, and she kept saying, before she even started, she says, I'm already healed. I'm already healed. Went through chemo treatment number two. I'm already healed. And so the idea, she kept saying it, then she started. Most of us want to see it first, then we say it. We're not from Missouri to show me state. We find ourselves, when we say it, we're going to see it. So this idea, so even though it may seem like there's some obstacles right now that are overcoming you, we are determined before we leave this month, we are determined to be a church that's going to walk and overflow and also overtake and also overcome. Can you join me right now if you're ready to make sure we are working and walking in that point as well? So I want to give us some spiritual principles. Gave you one last week. And every week on your notes, I want you just to add, we're going to have a different or a new spiritual principle every week to help us really understand this whole beautiful concept of overcoming. The first spiritual principle we talked about last week was simply this. Read this with me, please, together. Stop talking about the obstacles or problems. Keep going with me. Start talking to the obstacles and problems. Stop talking about, that's in order to overcome, at some point, we have to stop talking about the obstacle. Anybody can describe a mountain. Anybody can describe a problem. Anybody can talk about how heavy it is, how hard it is, how rough it is. But at some point, that's the way the world handles this. The world will talk about a problem. But we now have spiritual revelation, and we have spiritual insight, that we now start talking to the problem and talk to the obstacle. And again, now we talked about this last week to give us scripturally in the Old Testament and also the New Testament. What do we have in the New Testament? From 1 Samuel chapter 17, 45 through 46, we have David here. And once again, you recall the story. Goliath was 9 feet 9 inches high. The end of his spear wore 25 pounds. He was trained as a warrior from birth. Well, even though he was trained from a warrior, he taunted. He was on this side. There was a battle between them, God's people on this side. And he said, for 40 days, send somebody to fight me. And if they beat me, we'll serve you all. But if I beat them, you all serve us. And although God's people were over here trained, they were so intimidated by the size of Goliath, they were paralyzed. Anybody know an obstacle, if we keep on looking at the obstacle long enough, it can paralyze us? You keep on looking at this obstacle long enough, and it looks like there's no way to overcome it, and we get stuck and find ourselves not being able to go forward, because all we see is the obstacle. But what we find right here, so David shows up, actually make a takeout order. He was delivering food to the soldiers. And he went in and he says, who is this uncircumcised Philistine mocking and defaming the name of my God? So you remember the story? Then David says, look, I've already defeated a bear. I've already defeated a lion. So I'm going to take this Philistine out as well. Now look what happened. Then Saul, as you recall, gave David his armor. David put it on and said it. It says in the scripture, he tried to prove it. In other words, it didn't fit. So he put it off. And what are we saying here again for spiritual principle one? We can't take opinions and advice from anybody. Everybody has an opinion. So everybody's trying to put on you what they would do. And you don't listen to somebody who's worse off than you? They're going to listen to somebody. A married person should not be listening to an unmarried person about how to handle their wife. Now, they got to make sure that at this point, so they said, although I tried it on for a minute, it didn't fit me. So what I'm offering here is that there's some spiritual Holy Ghost advice that comes straight from the Word of God that fits who we are, and in turn, that's what we go in with instead. So here David was. So I don't know how big that thing was, but what a wonderful analogy. If you look at this picture here and assume you're David, what is David running away?
No.
What's he doing? Running toward him. And so if you look at the scripture, then Goliath said, when he saw David, said, why would y'all send a dog like this to me? What did David do? What's our spiritual principle number one? What is it again? It's what? Stop talking about the problem. Are y'all here? And do what? Start talking to. This is a good word today. So the idea was, so David decided all God's people before then were talking about how big Goliath was. David went up and started talking to Goliath and says, you know what? You come to me with sword and spear, but I come to you in the name of the Lord, and I'm about to take your head off. Now look, David's not running toward him, and the word now, and this is probably more visual, they took a stone, hit a Goliath, killed him, because he talked to his problem, and not about his problem. Is everybody with me? It's about time to stop talking to our problem, and not just about our problem. The next verse we talked about last week, was from Mark 11:23 and 24. Mark